and welcome to The Collegium, our monthly magazine program in three parts: cinema, state of affairs, and our arts calendar. Tonight's special program entitled Jazz, Music from the United States of America to the World with Love. Our cinema presentation is the 11th International Jazz Festival at Sea. For our state of affairs, we have our usual panelists, Dr. Temba Kadali and Charles Achie Odong. Our guest panelists are Reggie Moore, Cornelia Moore, Fawzi Abdul Khaliq, Michael Clifton, and Earl Bostic. Last but not least, our arts calendar with the above named artists. So stay with us and remember, you are participating in The Collegium.
Rhapsody, docked in the Tunisian Bay, the Kenny Burrell Benny Golson All-Stars performed one of jazz's respected numbers, A Night in Tunisia.
Welcome to our State of Affairs portion of the program. We are very pleased this evening to have as guest Mr. Reggie Moore, Mrs. Connie Moore, Fawazi Abdul Khaliq, Mr. Earl Bostic, and Mr. Michael Clifton, along with our regular panelists, Mr. Tema Kadali and Mr. Charles Achie Odong. To begin the informational flow, I'd like to drop the bomb on someone and just ask you, how do you define the term jazz, and what is the relationship of jazz to rhythm and blues, rock and roll, and soul? Who's first?
I say
my definition of jazz is two criteria, that it must somewhere have spontaneity and improvisation, and it has to swing. And by that, I don't mean it has to be a swing beat, but that whatever rhythm it is, that it's got a groove, it's got a swing somewhere. So that's my feeling on jazz. And the relation, what was it? The
relation to rhythm and blues?
The relationship to rhythm and blues, soul, rock and roll, is all with the blues. Because it all has the blues in it, all these musics. With jazz. Jazz is the blues, rock and roll is the blues, rhythm and blues is the blues, everything's the blues.
I'd like to extend that definition just a little bit, because there's some different forms of music that have improvisation and that really swing, I mean that really grooves and you pat your feet to it, but they come from India, they come from Asia, it's come from other places. So jazz is a specific type of swing. Typical type of feel, and it came from the slaves that were brought over to America, and they developed an art form in America. This is the only American art form.
True American art form.
Further comments?
Yeah, each one of these art forms, jazz, rhythm and blues, rock and roll, they all emphasize certain parts, because all of them contain improvisation to some extent. All of them contain certain rhythms. Even classical music has syncopation once in a while. But it's what you actually dwell on, what you exploit. Jazz has probably more syncopation than classical music. Jazz might bring out more complex chords in terms of extending the chord up past the 9th, 11th, 13th, flat this and flat that. Although the contemporary classical music has the same thing, jazz dwells more on the rhythm of it. Classical music might hit upon some of these things and go on to something else, and jazz might dwell on a certain beat and stay on it a longer time. Rock and roll might emphasize, and blues might emphasize the backbeat. What is the backbeat? That's the second and fourth beat of 1, 2, 3, 4, one, two, really bringing that out. And singers who sing to that, they really rely on that backbeat in order to express themselves. Soul is bringing in the emotional parts of your singing, what the pain and the blues and everything that what that means to you. Okay?
Charles, please.
Yeah, I'm interested in knowing the cultural and historical influences that inspired jazz.
Yeah, well, naturally, the cultural influences that inspired jazz are the influence from the stolen Africans that were taken to the United States about 400 years ago, the African Americans which live there now. Through this culture, through the experiences that they experienced in the under the slave trade and during the slave movement, up until the emancipation and beyond, these experiences grew and built into a form of culture, a form of art singing that they call the Phil Hollers. They're doing through planning and singing. From this comes through the blues, the so-called blues. And at the beginning times, this was the time when each individual was capable of singing the blues, and everyone understood that everybody had this blues and they could sing it. And then as the time went on into the early 1900s, the form of this blues changed a little to become done on the stage and theater during the minstrels times. And from this, at this same moment, this so-called music they call jazz, which is, for me, is not a very nice category, but it's the category we use now, sprung up. And that, what I believe, was the historical and cultural influences.
Any comments on that? No, I don't have anything more to add to that. Okay. I think we can go to the next question. Yeah.
How is jazz to be compared to the so-called serious or classical music?
Well, I think in order to answer that, one will first have to define what we mean by serious, because as we discussed before, we are labeling here. We are labeling in terms of bad connotation, good connotation, like what's worth more, what's more accepted by society. And in German, we actually make the distinction between ernste Musik and Unterhaltungsmusik, but putting more cultural emphasis and more value and more importance on the ernste Musik, which I feel is not right and is not fair, because to me, jazz actually is like Black American classical music. That's what it is to me. And it deserves the same value and the same support that classical music is getting. Like the Opera House in Berlin is subsidized, I don't know by how much every year, but I don't know of one concert hall in Berlin that specializes on jazz and that provides a platform for jazz artists and gives that kind of promotion, financial promotion. Okay.
And how would you then define serious music or classical music? Formally define it.
How would I formally define it?
Yeah, yes.
Well, to me, music is something that comes from the individual, and it has to do with how much work you put in as the individual. And I'm a jazz musician and jazz singer, and I take my work very serious. I mean, what is serious? Is it comic, or what is it? To me, it is the work that you put into your field, the dedication, and the talent. And to me, there is no difference between the classical and the jazz. Like, actually, if you go back, classical music, when it first developed years, centuries ago, those musicians were improvising. They had actually jam sessions just like jazz musicians. It's just not too many people know about this today. But when Mozart played, he improvised, and they had contests. They got together and improvised. But it became a certain norm, because then music was notated and a certain improvisation became a sonata or a fugue or whatever, and then we play it today. But that's how jazz pieces developed also.
Okay.
Well, tell me, while we're developing music and all these other things, what are some of the economic realities that are associated with composing or playing this music?
Well, I think that most people that pursue jazz don't do it for the money. They do it for the love. They know that their future is not going to be guaranteed with millions of dollars or millions of marks.
That's right.
I can't say that for other types of music, but one of the economic realities is that you might not be rich and famous. You might be famous and not rich. You might not become a multi-millionaire pursuing jazz, but you do it because you love the culture of it and you love the feeling of it.
What are the realities of playing jazz, the economic realities of playing jazz in Berlin or in Europe so far for the group of you?
Well, I think Connie touched on one phase of it. It's certain institutions here, especially here in Germany, are supported by the government with government money. And, well, you know, the Deutsche Oper, or the classical music scene, and the jazz scene is not supported by the government. And so whatever we have to struggle for ourselves, we have to make sure that we get enough jobs with it, and then that makes it more difficult for us to make a living at it than say somebody who is what do you call a Babta in Philharmonic.
Yeah, most of us are not only making money, are only making money playing jazz. We have to do a lot of different kind of music, so a lot of different types of performances, which can include other kinds of funk groups, or blues groups, theater, dance groups, everything, just to survive. But as a jazz musician and playing only jazz, it's very difficult, I think, not just here in Berlin, but also in the rest of the world.
Sure.
There are those people from racial backgrounds who feel there is specific music to be portrayed by designated racial groups. How do you feel or respond to this issue?
Anybody?
Well, okay, I guess I have something to say to that. My situation is pretty different over here, being German, being white, and being a jazz singer. And I think I'm experiencing a little bit what Marian Anderson experienced, or Paul Robeson experienced in their days when they made it into the opera houses. And for me, it's sometimes pretty difficult because people walk up to me and ask me, why do you sing jazz? You're German, you're white, do you have the right voice for this? Or, you know, you don't have the background. And I've also been outright attacked by different people for singing jazz. But I believe that, to me, jazz is one of the most democratic art forms in this world. And so I just go ahead and do what I feel comes from my heart, and I try to just go my way. Period. But I think it's sometimes pretty difficult.
Further questions?
Well, as a player, when I play, I would like to be surrounded with the best musicians.
Right.
It doesn't help me if I'm playing with all black musicians and the feeling's not there. And that happens quite a lot sometimes. Just because everybody's black doesn't mean everything's happening. So. You want the best. If you're getting ready to be operated on, and the doctor's getting ready to put the scalpel, so you want him to be the best doctor.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same thing in music. It's a double-edged sword. Some of the rules that you have for applying certain racial quotas or certain racial preferences can backfire on you. And what's good for some people are not good for everybody.
Yeah, I don't think there are any cultural boundaries to what you to music or to sports or anything like that. I mean, if you feel pulled to a certain type of music, I'm sure there would be many, many more American blacks playing in symphony orchestras if they were given an opportunity years ago to study instruments. And I'm sure that we would be a lot more white blues singers and players if they were given the opportunity. So it is no cultural limitation, it's just a social and limitation that we set on ourselves.
Yeah, social and nationalist, because I mean, you have people who are Chinese and they do Chinese music and they want white Europeans playing authentic Chinese music or Brazilian music or Tibetan music. I mean, music should be in itself open, it's a universal language, and it could be taught and learned by all peoples of the planet. And so the jazz, in the same respect, can also be performed and played by everyone. But of course, like Reggie said, you should have the best musicians around you, no matter what it is.
Timber.
How much of a factor is the culture determined in regards to excellence of a player composer, or the lack of thereof?
Well, I would say culture is nearly everything from what you get, and it goes back to what Fawazi was saying of anybody can play jazz, but you have to get into it. It's your experiences that make you what that is. So if you hear a record, maybe you hear a record and you're young and you get turned on, you want to get more records and you keep going. And you have your culture then. You get into the jazz culture, you become a jazz musician. You look for your teachers and listen to your masters.
Further comments? Well, thank you very much. And now we will go to our arts calendar. And remember, you are participating in the Collegium. We'll be right back.
Let the angels sing safe and sound when old midnight, good old midnight, comes
thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.